says you're live now.
Mm-hmm. And it's 5 o'clock, and it's time to start. It seems we've stood and talked like this before. We looked at each other in the same way then, but I can't remember. This process. Somehow it was plugged in backwards. I know.
Okay.
Just once I want this thing to go technically smoothly. Just once I get started, it says I have 20% battery left. Mark Swink says he's not getting anything but a circle. Are you getting it better now, Mark? Huh?
Just the ceiling.
Well, yeah, but it takes like 3 minutes, three seconds or something. I'm back now. I'll be back. Mark, are you actually getting my picture? I can't tell.
I've got it now.
You've got it? We'll try this again. Someday this will go smoothly. Same way then, but I can't remember where.
or when. The clothes you're wearing are the clothes you wore. The smile you were smiling then, but I can't remember when or when. Some things that happen for the first time to be happening again, and so it seems that we have met before and laughed before and loved before, but who knows where or when. And so it seems that we have met before and laughed before and loved before, but who knows where or when. Chair, it's so good to have you here. How I love when friends and family come to call. Just relax and unwind, sit and say what's on your mind. It's been quite a while, I wanna hear it all. You know, time with friends has a joy that's all its own. Sharing love, sharing laughs as we travel down our roads. Yes, our time with friends is just as good as it can be. Come on in and spend some time with me. Would you like something to eat? I can whip us up a treat. Let me throw another log upon the fire. Make yourself all at home. Don't stand out there on your own. Come on in so we can lift our spirits higher. You know, time with friends is a part of life's design. Telling jokes, shedding tears, making sure we're doing fine. Yes, that's time with friends. It's just as often as can be. Please come on in and spend some time with me. Come on in and spend some time with me.
Good evening, or afternoon, depending on which coast you're on. Welcome to the March 2021 Time with Friends. I'm David Duvall. We're going to be celebrating Rodgers and Hart today. We're trying a new camera angle. Might not be able to tell the difference, but there is one. If you are my Facebook friend, which you kind of have to be watching this, make sure you tune in to my Facebook page a little later today. I'm going to post the picture of what it looks like to get this camera angle, because it's highly entertaining. No roses today because, well, frankly, Fred Meyer didn't have any. But we have these beautiful daffodils joining us today, which is great, behind me giving some sort of acknowledgement that it's spring. The lovely Penny is over on the chair by the fire. Are you warm enough now?
I am. It feels good.
Oh, good. Keeping me company and some amount of live laughter so that I know that, you know, it's either working or it's not. Because of this new angle, I can't put this sign up all the time, so now I have to be slightly more vulgar and less subtle about it and say, here is the info that you need to give me a tip or a donation or something to say you enjoyed the show, so that I will keep doing these. There's the Venmo address and the PayPal address, and if those don't work for you, PM me. And I will send you my mailing address and you can put a check in the mail. I think I'm going to try this here. I was going to put it over there, but it's closer there. Okay. Rodgers and Hart. Why Rodgers and Hart? Well, because I like them. And a year ago this month, March 4th, actually, I made my debut at Egan's Cabaret doing an hour of Rodgers and Hart. And then 3 days later, all performance venues shut down. So it's kind of like I'm picking back up where I left off, except we're really not open
yet, but it's close. Rodgers and Hart are slightly less familiar with the current age group of folks than Rodgers and Hammerstein, but it's an interesting thing because Rodgers and Hart wrote 28 stage musicals and the music for 4 films that were films only. A lot of their stage musicals became films, but they wrote 4 film only things. And Rodgers and Hammerstein only wrote 9 musicals and 1 film and 1 television show, so their output was much less. It's just that they were much more successful at it. Rodgers and Hart together wrote about, well, just over 500 songs. I was trying to look up the exact number and failed to locate that. They worked from 1919. Their first song was the thing called Any Old Place With You, which is not a bad song, but I'm not doing it today. It was in a 1919 show called A Lonely Romeo. I have to look that up right there. Their last collaboration was a revival of A Connecticut Yankee in King Arthur's Court, which opened about 6 months after Oklahoma opened. And the reason that Richard Rodgers wanted to work with somebody other than Mr. Hart, who I affectionately refer to as Larry, was because Larry stopped showing up for work sober and it was just really too difficult to do. And in fact, on the opening night of the revival of Connecticut Yankee, he was barred from the theater, but he came in anyway into the lobby into a drunken stupor and was thrown out in the rain and died of pneumonia 2 days later in the hospital. So there you go. Thank you, Mark, for posting that info for people to find. I like that very much. Well, of the 500 songs that they wrote, I'm going to do about 20 today. Facebook Live has cut me off in the past before I'm done for some reason. If that happens, I'll be right back. Come right back with me. But I'm going to start with a medley of 2 songs which always have entertained me. Why? Okay, excuse me again. It's telling me that my battery is low and I've got it plugged in. I shouldn't. Is the green extension cord plugged in, Penny?
Over here, you mean?
Yeah.
I don't see a green one.
All right, well, if I get shut down, I'm going to come back again. I don't know. Okay, well, I don't know why I'm having this problem. The tech gods just don't like my doing this. Anyway, here we go. 2 songs by Rodgers and Hart. In the spring when the feeling was chronic and my caution was leaving me flat, I could have made use of a tonic before you gave me that. Mental deficient, you'll grade me. I've given you plenty of data. You came, you saw, and you slayed me. And that-a was that-a. I'm a sentimental sap, that's all. What's the use in trying not to fall? I have no will. You made your kill, 'cause you took advantage of me. Just like an apple on a bough, and you're gonna shake me down somehow. So what's the use? You've cooked my goose. You took advantage of me. I'm so hot and bothered that I don't know my elbow from my ear. Something awful each time you go. It's much worse when you're near. Here I am with all my bridges burned, just a babe in arms where you're concerned. So lock the doors and call me yours, 'cause you took advantage of me. If my heart gets in your hair, you mustn't kick it around. If you're bored with this affair, and give it around. Even though I'm mild and meek, when we have a brawl, if I turn the other cheek, try to ring the bell. You never go for the sound. The next guy might not do as well. You mustn't kick it around. I'm so hot and bothered that I don't know my elbow from my ear. I suffer something awful each time you go. It's much worse when you're near. With the juice. Maybe I finally got it figured out. Here's one that I've absolutely loved for a very long time. I've never met you, yet never doubt, dear. I can't forget you. I thought you out, dear. I know your profile, and I know the way you kiss. Just the thing I miss on a night like this. If dreams were made of imagination, I'm not afraid of my own creation. With all my heart is here for you to take. Why should I quake? I'm not awake. Isn't it romantic? Music in the night, a dream that can't be heard. Isn't it romantic? Moving shadows right, the oldest magic. Was very fond of women. She was a girl who was very fond of men. She had a taste for both corpulent and slim men. He wouldn't look at a lady under 10. She went abroad just to find a man to marry. He went abroad just to find himself a wife. She didn't want any Tom or Dick or Harry. He shot a mate who'd be true for him for life. She fell in love with the angle of his eyebrow. He fell in love with the dimple on his knee. And when they wed, and we went around with other women, and they went with other men, and that is he and she. Damn, there's a lot of words in that. That's for my friend Val, who also sang that song in a production she did of The Boys from Syracuse. It's supposed to be done by two people, which would allow you to breathe and then catch the next phrase when it comes back around. But I keep doing it as a solo, and then I trip over my tongue. So, you know, there you have it. Not every song that becomes a hit starts out as a hit. Sometimes they, you know, have to take their own journey to get there. And I'm going to tell you the story now of the most famous, I think, of the Rodgers and Hart songs. It's certainly the most enduring, and it keeps coming back every now and then in a new arrangement, Conquering Time. It began as a ballad written for Jean Harlow. And, of course, we all know what a beautiful musical talent Jean Harlow was. That was sarcasm, in case you missed it. For a musical called Hollywood Parade. And this is how the song was first heard. Oh, Lord, if you ain't busy up there, I ask for help with a prayer. So please don't give me the air. Oh, hear me, Lord. I must see Garbo in person with Gable when they're rehearsing, while some director is cursing. Please let me open up my eyes at 7 and find I'm looking through the Golden Gate and walking right into my movie heaven, while some director tells me I'll be great. Oh Lord, I know how friendly you are if I'm not going too far. Be nice and wake me a star. I don't know why that wasn't a hit. I really don't. It makes no sense to me. Well, it wasn't. So they liked the music. They shelved it. And then in the 1934 movie Manhattan Melodrama, they decided to perhaps use it as the theme song. So it was reinvented. Act One. Up your coffee and run into the subway, you crowd. Don't breathe, it isn't allowed. See, balance right there. Act Two, the boss is yelling at you. You feel so frightened and cowed. Don't breathe, it isn't allowed. The rows of skyscrapers are like a canyon, hidden beneath a stony shroud. 8 million people and not one companion. Don't speak to anyone, it's not allowed. Act Three, you hate the sight of Broadway. It's just that type of a play. Manhattan Melodrama. Didn't exactly scan out the way that it should have. So they dropped it before the film was released. A good idea. And they reworked it for an actress named Shirley Ross to sing in the movie. And then it turned out like this. Oh Lord, what is the matter with me? I'm just permitted to see every man. Oh, hear me, Lord. I could be good to a lover, but then I always discover the bad in every man. They like to tell you that they love you only, and you believe them, though you know you're wrong. A little ballroom can be awfully lonely, and a night can be so very long. Oh, the bad in every man. It's still in the movie. You can see it. It's there. I've watched it. Well, of course, we all know that that still didn't make a hit. And they, or actually not they, Larry, reworked the words one more time and put it out on a radio show, not connected to a Broadway production. And this time, it's the words we all know. And please, feel free to join along. When I'm doing this live, I always have the audience sing along with me at this point. And they love it because everyone knows these words. Blue moon, you saw me standing alone, without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own. Saying a prayer for someone I really do care for. And then there suddenly appeared before me the only one my arms will ever hold. I heard somebody whisper, please adore me. And when I looked, the moon had turned to gold. Blue moon, without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own, without a love of my Okay, this is bad form, but I'm going to do that one more time because I can do it. Whisper low, but don't say no. It's such a quiet night. See, I can't do it. If I get the phlegm out of my throat, it's great. All right, thank you for that. This next song I'm going to do for my friend Cheryl in Port Angeles. She said she wanted to make a request, but whatever I chose was fine. So there you go. This is another one of their very famous songs. I've had to adapt it so that I, as a male human, can sing it because I didn't want to be the type of male human that would have to sing it personally. That'll make sense in a minute. She works at the palace ballroom, but gee, that palace is cheap. When she gets back to her chilly ballroom, it's much too tired to sleep. She's one of those lady teachers, a beautiful hostess, you know, the one that the palace features at exactly a dime a throw. $0.10 a dance, that's what they pay her. Gosh, how they weigh her down. $0.10 a dance, pansies and rough guys, tough guys who tear her gown. 7 to midnight, she hears drums. Loudly the saxophone blows. Trumpets are tearing her eardrums. Customers crush her toes. Sometimes she thinks she's found her hero, but it's a queer romance. All that they need is a ticket. Come on, big boy, 10 cents a dance. Fighters and sailors and bow-legged tailors can pay for their tickets and rent her. Butchers and barbers and rats from the harbors are sweethearts her good luck has sent her. Though she's a chorus of elderly beaux, stockings are porous with holes in the toe. She's there till closing time. Dance and be merry, it's only a dime. Sometimes she thinks she's found her hero, but it's a queer romance. All that they need is a ticket. Come on, big boy. 10 cents a dance. Terry wants to know what that would translate into today. Probably $5. But it's been a while since I was a working taxi dancer in New York City. Speaking of New York, summer journeys to Niagara and to other places aggravate all our cares. We'll save our fares. I've a cozy little flat in what is known as Old Manhattan. We'll settle down right here in town. We'll take Manhattan, the Bronx, and Staten Island too. It's lovely going through the zoo. It's very fancy on Old Delancey Street, you know. The subway chugs us so, where balmy breezes blow to and fro. And tell me what street compares with Mott Street in July. Sweet push carts gently gliding by. See We'll bathe at Brighton, the fish you'll frighten when you swim. Your bathing suit's so thin, we'll make the shellfish grin, fin to fin. I'd like to take a sail on Jamaica Bay with you, and fair Canarsie's lake we'll view. The city's bustle cannot destroy the dreams of a girl and boy. We'll turn Manhattan into an Isle of Joy. We'll go to Yonkers, where true love conquers in the wild, and starve together, dear, in Childs. We'll go to Coney and get baloney on a roll. In Central Park we'll stroll, where our first kiss we stole, so to soul. We'll have some babies, they will see AB's Irish Rose. Perhaps they'll live to see it close. The city's clamor can never spoil, here it comes, the dreams of a boy and Goyle. We'll turn Manhattan into an Isle of Joy. That last rhyme always makes me laugh. Okay. This is one of their prettier efforts. Wait till you see her. See how she looks. Wait till you hear her laugh. Painters of paintings, writers of books, never could know the half. Wait till you feel the warmth of her glance, pensive and sweet and thrilling. I'll never be willing to free her. When you see her, you won't believe your eyes. No, you won't believe your eyes. Personally, I like Larry's writing best when he's being romantic. It seems to really work. There's not a lot of those, because he's pretty sarcastic and sardonic most of the time. But that one I do care for. Now, Valerie, part two. Let's see if I can fare better this time. He always said, I would like to have a daughter. She always said, I would like to have a son. She took to kids like a duckling takes to water. He always thought having babies would be fun. He told her this on the very day he met her. She said the wish was the father to the sport. He bought a house in the nursery he set her. She helped a stork make his annual report. He won renown as the father of a squadron. She won awards for her prolificity. And just because they loved each other, they got married after all. And that is he and she. There you go. Penny is laughing. These are two songs I've Valerie says, and you do it again? No, I'm okay. I don't need the oxygen yet. But if you've got a, what do they call those things? You know, with where you stick it in your system and you squeeze and you pull all the crap out of your throat. That I could use.
Ow.
You schedule a concert and, you know, you think you're going to be okay. And then all of a sudden, pollen hits the air. Yay! All right. So here are two songs that I've hooked together because I think they're fun as a combo. I am going to wager that my friend Mark is the only one who's going to remember the song in the middle. I could be wrong, but... My romance doesn't have to have a moon in the sky. My romance doesn't need a blue lagoon standing by. No month of May, no twinkling stars, no hideaway, no soft guitar. Doesn't need a castle rising in Spain, or a dance to a constantly surprising refrain. Wide awake, I can make my most fantastic dreams come true. My romance doesn't need a thing but you. And everyone I meet that you and I are sweethearts. I'll shout it out from the roof. I'll give the papers proof that we two are complete hearts. I want the world to know. Surprising refrain. Wide awake, I can make my most fantastic dreams come true. My romance doesn't need a thing. My romance doesn't need a thing. My romance doesn't need a thing. But you. As I said, I like Larry best when he's being romantic. My friend Joanne requested this next song. In truth, it's not one I like very much, but I like Joanne very much. So I'm gonna do it for her. In a mountain greenery where the scenery just two crazy people together. While you love your lover, let blue skies be your coverlet. When it rains, we'll laugh at the weather. And if you're good, I'll search for so you can cook while I stand looking. Beans could get no keener. in a beanery, bless our mountain greenery home. Bless our mountain greenery home. That was the hit song from a show called Garrick Gaieties, which debuted in 1926. Now, this is the, if you watch my concerts, my monthly concerts regularly, you know that there's every show I make sure I put in something that scares me. This is the one, this song here right now. It's coming up. This is the one that I'm really going to try this in public. I really am. This is another song from Garrick Gaieties that I found on a recording, one of the many Ben Bagley recordings of lost songs by famous composers. And I just lifted it because it makes me laugh. And legitimately, Mr. Finley, this one is for you. I'm Elizabeth the Virgin Queen. Don't laugh. On my title I stand firm, though it's just a technical term. My royal bed was only used by half. I have never been a prude, or I'd have not been born a Tudor. A royal marriage is a mockery. A husband's just a bit of crockery. There's not much I haven't seen, but I'm still the Virgin Queen. But even a queen has her moments, and I see no reason to rue it. A venial sin is no menial sin. In fact, it's quite a congenial sin if nobody sees you do it. My portal, I am mortal, and the court'll still be blind. Though there's urge in me, a virgin, I'm a virgin in my mind. The rumors you've heard about Shakespeare are vulgar as they are untrue. I was his inspiration to help out the nation. And one must have a moment or two. Yes, even a queen has her moments. When regal wild oats need their sowing, I'll eat alone, drink my tea alone, and make England queen of the sea alone. For sailors are so worth knowing. All my gallants had their talents. They were balance for my nerves. When my army failed to charm me, I would call out the reserves. You think Mary Stuart was naughty, the blonde with the big eyes of blue, but no royal redhead was ever a deadhead, and one must have a moment or two. Yes, even a queen has her moments. The duty is stern as a Tartar. A tall he man and an all he man was that handsome Sir Walter Raleigh man. And what a knight of the garter! When was Floody o'er the mud he threw his mantle down for me? In his shirt he proved a flirt. He was more daring vis-a-vis. They say he discovered tobacco, and I made him smoke, it is true. For my tresses, so Titian gave him the ignition. And one must have a moment or two. Yes, one must have a moment or two. Isn't that cute? There you go. All right. This next song is one that I recorded on the upcoming Bossa Nova CD that I'm getting ready to release. I tried to pick one thing from all the famous Broadway composers or composing teams, and this was the one I chose from Rodgers and Hart. It was not designed to be a bossa nova. It was written in 3/4 time, but you know, me. I like to sing and think outside the box. Just for the record, I am really going to miss Richard Cole's tenor saxophone cutting in here in a minute, but oh well. The most beautiful girl in the world picks my ties out, eats my candy, drinks my brandy. The most beautiful girl in the world. I need to show this again for those of you who want to throw a little something into the pot, which would be really, really appreciated since our entire live performance community got, you know, sort of put off to the side while we all tried to keep each other safe. So if you can put a little something, any amount, into this, one of these two accounts, it would be most, most appreciative. Appreciated? Appreciated of Penny says pull it back. Penny always says pull it back. There we go. No. There we go. Usually she means...
There we go.
Yeah, usually she doesn't mean the sign. She means the volume at which I'm talking. I get asked often, what is my favorite Cole Porter song? And I can't answer that question. I do, however, have an answer for what is my favorite Rodgers and Hart song. And this is it. Once I left, and I heard you sing that I'd be playing solitaire, uneasy in my easy chair. It never entered my mind. Once you told me I was mistaken, that I'd awaken with the sun and order orange juice for one. It never entered my mind. Have to scratch my back.
there again, to get into my hair again. It never entered my mind. I confess it, I didn't get it, that I would sit and mope again. And all the while I'd hope again to be your darling dope again. It never entered my mind.
Sitting right behind that as my favorite song is this next one I'm going to do, a very rarely performed song from a movie called Nana, N-A-N-A, that I've almost seen. It was on, but I only caught the last end of it on Turner Classic Movies one day, and this song wasn't part of what I saw. But I think of all the things that Larry Hart wrote, this is probably, in my opinion, this must be the most soul-revealing thing he ever put on paper. And while I no longer subscribe to this theory, it's an honor to be able to put this truth out into the world, because for a lot of people that I know, it has been a truth or stays a truth. Why say forever? There's never any love forever. But my dear, why not place my head between your arms in tenderest embrace? Love's but a moment that's splendid, although it may be ended. That's my way. Why regret that we met and loved today? Kiss me and say goodbye. That's love. Laugh with a gay goodbye. That's love. Press my body tight and hush my lips. Hush my lips with yours. Though it's just a night, why measure it? Treasure it. It's yours. If I'm your light of love, thank you. sigh. I'll never ask you why. That's love. Goodbye. There's a third one. She was as pure as the snow before it's driven. He never smoked and he never touched a drop. When she said boo, he would always be forgiven. When he would swim, he would always wear the top. She wore no rouge, though she had a bad complexion. He always prayed every time he went to bed. She was so kind that she hated vivisection. He loved his ma and he swore he'd never wed. She was so chaste that it made her very nervous. He loved to go to the vicarage for tea. And when they died, and when they died and went to heaven, all the angels moved to hell. And that is he and she. Of all of them, that one came out of my mouth tonight the best. There we go. Thank you very much for joining me tonight for our monthly time with friends. Hope you had a good time. I'm sorry the pollen is wreaking havoc with my voice today. I know I'm not supposed to apologize for that, but you know, I feel bad. This is helping, chicken broth, hot chicken broth, soothes the cords. I'm going to leave you with one more medley, then I'm going to sign off and wish you all a great month. I'm up for ideas on what you might like to see as a theme for my April show. I haven't any thoughts about that. I'm pretty sure that because he was born in May is going to be an Irving Berlin hour. But I'm up for suggestions for April.
April in Paris.
Penny says April in Paris.
Oh, okay.
But there you go. That's one song. I suppose I could do a Paris thing. Well, we'll think about it. Anyway, here's my farewell for today. Thanks again. All right. This one takes a little... If I up here more than I want to be, it's because this has a lot of words. I've got $5. I'm in good condition. And I've got ambition that belongs to you. 6 shirts and collars, debts beyond endurance, on my life insurance, that belongs to you. I've got a heart that must be certain, just be certain, I'll be true. Take my $5, take my shirts and collars, take my heart that hollers, everything I've got belongs to you. I have eyes for you to give you dirty looks. I have words that do not come from children's books. I have a lot of them. There are tricks with a knife I'm learning to do. And everything I've got belongs to you. I've a powerful anesthesia in my fist. And the perfect wrist to give your neck a twist. There are hammerlock holds, I've mastered a few. And everything I've got belongs to you. Share for share, share alike. You get struck each time I strike. You for me and me for you. I'll give you plenty of nothing. I'm not yours for better, but for worse. And I've learned to give that well-known witch's curse. I've a terrible tongue, a temper for two. And everything I've got belongs to you. I've got $5, 85 relations, 2 lace combinations, they belong to you. 2 coats with collars, Ma and Grandma wore 'em. All the Ma's adore 'em, they belong to you. I've got 2 lips that care for mating, therefore waiting will not do. Take my $5, take my coats and collars, take my heart that hollers, 'cause every Everything I've got belongs to you. Everything I've got belongs to you. Everything I've got belongs to you. Thank you very much. See you next month. Bye-bye.